Hi friends, in this video we'll discuss the images of anesthesia from which image based MCQs will be asked. Let's crack it. We'll start. The first image, this is an image of Byers block. You can see this image is of Byers block. In this image, you can see there is a tourniquet is applied over the arm and IV cannula is there on the dorsum of the hand. From here, we give the local anesthetics by IV cannula. And so when, because cuff is inflated, so a local anesthetic will remain there. So that limb will be anesthetized. This is also known as IVRA block because we are giving the drug into intravenous. That's why it is known as intravenous regional anesthesia, and the drug contraindicated in Byers block is bupivacaine. You can remember like BB, bupivacaine, that is contraindicated in Byers block. Next image, you can see this is an oxygen concentrator. This oxygen concentrator is as the its name. It's this instrument concentrate the oxygen from the environment, from the air. It will suck the air from the environment. From there, nitrogen is adsorbed, not absorbed, it is adsorbed, and oxygen is given. And by this equipment, maximum oxygen that can be given is 96% of oxygen. This instrument cannot give 100% oxygen. And most of the cases, even we don't need the 100% oxygen. So it is more than sufficient for, in many cases. It is used where oxygen cylinder or the oxygen gas supply is not available, so it can be used at home. The many image based MCQs are asked related to the capnography. You can see capnography is the graphical presentation of the carbon dioxide in respiratory gases versus time. So the when during expiration, when the expiratory gases are vented out, first the respiratory gases will come out from this anatomical dead space. So the anatomical dead space, there is a no gas exchange occurs, so there will be no carbon dioxide. You can see this is the baseline, no carbon dioxide. As the alveolar part will increase, amount of carbon dioxide will increase, but after some time, when all this anatomical dead space gases are vented out, only the alveolar gases will be vented out, and it will represent it as a plateau, continuous CO2 concentration. And the end of the expiration, there is a red one. You can see this is the inspiratory part. When during inspiration, there is a no carbon dioxide in inspiratory gases. So this graph will touch the baseline. So many MCQs have been asked. This plateau represent the alveolar. This represent the mixture of the alveolar and the dead space. And this represent the dead space. This is how the normal capnograph looks like. And depending upon the different shapes, different MCQs have been asked, we will discuss. This is the shark fin appearance. Means this on the graph, it will looks like this. Why it is known as shark fin appearance? Because its shape is like fin of the shark. That's why it is known as shark fin appearance. This type of capnograph you will see in bronchospasm. This is the curulical left, very commonly asked in AIIMS and NEET exams. If there is any dip in during the plateau phase, you can see this is a dip. This is known as curare cleft. Means this time the patient is having spontaneous effort during paralysis. Patient is trying to take the spontaneous breath. That's why it is known as curare cleft. Curare means muscle action. During muscle action, patient is trying to take the spontaneous breath. So what you will do? Definitely you will give. If you are in the middle of the surgery, you will supplement with the muscle action. This is the ripple effect. You can the end of the expiration and the inspiratory part, you will see like this seesaw appearance. This is known as ripple effect or also known as cardiac oscillations. Cardiac oscillations. And this graph is seen in thin patient and the pediatric patient. Thin patient or pediatric patient. And this graph you can see continuously the capnograph height is increasing. and rate is very low. So this is representing hypoventilation. There is a hypoventilation due to which there is an increase in capnograph height. And this is apnea. Up to this, the graph was normal, and then there is a straight line. Means there is no carbon dioxide. It may be due to the any ventilator failure, tube disconnection, tube tinking, or the tube dislodgement, or cardiac arrest. So many reasons are there. One of them is if endotracheal tube is dislodged, or endotracheal tube is by chance in esophagus. If endotracheal tube is in esophagus, you will get this kind of capnograph straight line. This is the rebreathing. This is the inspiratory part. So the inspiratory part should come to the baseline, but it is not coming to the baseline. It is just coming up to this point. Means some amount of carbon dioxide is there. It means the patient is breathing the carbon dioxide. That's why there is a rebreathing. This is a deflated endotracheal cuff. If endotracheal cuff is deflated, you will get this kind of graph. If there is a double peaks, 1-1. This type of graph you will get severe kyphoscoliosis or lung transplant. Means there is no synchronization between the two lungs. Then you will get this kind of capnograph, double hump capnograph. This is capnograph. You can see that at the end of the expiration, there is an increase in carbon dioxide level. This appearance is particularly known as pigtail appearance. Pigtail appearance. And this capnograph is seen in any condition where there is a low lung compliance. Like in case of obesity, pregnancy. So these are the common capnographs that those can be asked in image-based MCQs. Because in the low compliance lungs, at the end of the expiration, there is a sudden squeezing of the alveoli and there is a sudden rise of carbon dioxide. And you will see this rise. Now another important topic from which MCQs have been asked, particularly image-based. In Swan-Ganz catheter that is passed from the internal jugular vein into the right atrium, from right atrium to the right ventricle to the pulmonary artery. When this Swan-Ganz catheter is inserted, at that time, how you will you know that the tip of the catheter is inside the right atrium, right ventricle or pulmonary artery? Because at this end, we attach the transducer, and by the tracing, we come to know whether the tip is inside the right atrium ventricle or pulmonary artery. If the graph is just like this, right atrium, CVP line, it is inside the right atrium. But as the systolic pressure is increased, you can see this blue one, the systolic upper one, is systolic pressure is increased. So it is, tip is inside the right ventricle. But as the tip will go into the pulmonary artery, that this lower part, diastolic part will increase. That is, diastolic pressure will increase. It means the tip of the catheter is inside the pulmonary artery. And when you will inflate the balloon, pulmonary capillary wedge pressure, graph will be like this. Examiner can show you any one of these graph and ask the where the tip of the Swan-Ganz catheter is present. Okay. This is a probe of the pulse oximeter. Finger can be inserted into this part and we can measure the oxygen saturation of the arterial blood, because pulse oximeter sends only the pulsatile blood. That's why it tells about the oxygen saturation of arterial blood. This is a triple lumen center line. You can say this part of the center line will go into the vein, and this is the three lumens, they will remain outside. This central line can be inserted into through the internal jugular vein or subclavian vein. Okay, this tip will go up to this at the junction of the right atrium and the superior vena cava, and these triple lumens remain outside. Guys, this is a anesthesia machine where cylinder is attached. You can see this cylinder is blue color. From color coding you can understand this is nitrous oxide cylinder, and this is the pressure gauge that will tell the pressure of the cylinder. And this is also color coded. You can appreciate this is the blue color. And the part of this anesthesia machine to which cylinders are attached. This is yoke assembly. Or you can say this whole part is a high pressure system. Yoke assembly, cylinder, and the pressure goes. And after up to the first pressure reducing valve. This is the yoke assembly. You can see this is the nipple where the cylinder gas outlet will attach, and there will be gas will enter into the nipple into the anesthesia machine. And these are the two pins from which many MCQs has been asked, what is the use of the pins index system. These are the two pins. These pins will go into the corresponding holes. Those are present on the cylinders, and when these corresponding holes will match these two pins, then only there will be tight fitting of cylinders. That's why this pin index prevent the wrong fitting of cylinders. After cylinder is attached here by this retaining screw, we will tighten the cylinders. Okay, so this is the yoke assembly. And this is a safety system to prevent the wrong attachment of central supply. Definitely, if their cylinders are there by pin index, we can prevent the wrong attachment of cylinders. But when gases comes through the central supply, how will you prevent the wrong attachment of gases? For that, there is a system, DIS, diameter index safety system. Diameter index safety system. This system, you can see this oxygen, this is nitrous oxide, these are the different diameters. They have different diameters. So the nitrous oxide pipe cannot be attached to the oxygen port, and oxygen cannot be attached to the nitrous oxide. So diameter index safety system were the four preventing the wrong attachment of center supply, while the pin index for the wrong attachment of cylinders only. This is a flow meter. You can see the flow control knobs, flow control knob, and these are the Thorpe tubes and with the markings. And these Thorpe tubes are made up of Pyrex glass. When you will open these flow control knobs, there is a bobbin that will rise, and by this we can assess the how much flow is going to the patient. You can see that flow control knobs are also color coding. This blue color is for the nitrous oxide and white one for the oxygen. Not only these probe knobs are the color coded, but they are also touch coded. In case of oxygen, there are the coarse serrations. While in case of nitrous oxide, there are fine serrations. You can appreciate if you are able to see. This is the part of, up to this part, it is a low pressure system. By this flow control knob, it will come into intermediate pressure system. Guys, examiner can ask, showing with the color of the vaporizer. This vaporizer is used for which inhalation agent? Halothane, isoflurane, ceofluorine, desflurane. There is a color coding already we discussed. This is for halothane. Halothane, red color. For iso, there is purple. For CO, yellow color. And for the desflurane, blue color is coded. So this is a vaporizer of halothane. Many questions have been asked from the manipulation systems. There are six circuits are there, A, B, C, D, E, F. Examiner can show you the image and ask the, recognize the system, manipulation system. Very easy, A, B, C, D, E, F. How can you recognize? In the first three, you will see on the patient side, this is the patient side. you will find the walls. Okay, while in the other three you will not find walls on the this side, by which you can definitely differentiate if wall is there patient side, it is ABC and not it is DEND. What are the other modifications? What are the other features by which you can recognize? Then this is the A circuit. You can see this is the wall towards the patient end, and this is the back. This A and B, you can see they are just opposite. Here the wall was the patient side, but in the D the wall has gone to the this end, and the back has shifted to the wall has this fresh gas flow. Sorry, fresh gas flow has shifted to the this side. That is the difference in A and D. While B and C both are same, looks like same, but only difference is that this corrugating tubing is not there in C. You can remember like B is bada, C is chota, that is slightly bigger one. B circuit is and C is smaller one. But the on the both wall or the fresh gas flow, this arrow means fresh gas flow towards the patient end. While the E circuit, there is no bag. When the bag is attached here, it will become F. I will show you individually. This is the Maplacian circuit, also known as McGill circuit. There is a fresh gas flow from this end, valve is towards the patient end. There is a one modification of Maplacian A or McGill circuit. This is the McGill circuit or the Maplacian A. It is modified by into Lex modification. What is the modification? You can see there is a wall towards the patient end in a Maplacian A. But instead of wall this side, that wall is shifted towards this side, and the expiratory gases will vented out through this inner pipe. There is a tube within tube. Okay, this inner tube is for the expiratory gases. So this is a type of coaxial circuit. This is a type of coaxial circuit, and the Lex circuit is a modification of Maplacian A or McGill. Both are same thing. And that is, this is the D, Maplacian D upper one. You can see that fresh gas flow towards the patient end and valve toward the other end, just opposite to the Maplacian A. And this Maplacian D is modified into Bain. A was modified into Lex, but D is modified into Bain's. What is modification? Here the fresh gas flow is supplied by one tubing, but in Bain circuit, another tube within tube by which the gases are supplied at the patient end. Here also gases are supplied at the patient end, but here also the by the tube within the tube system, gases are also provided the patient end. So this circuit also become coaxial, means tube within a tube. But what is the difference between the lag on the Bain? But here the inner tube is for the inspiratory gases, you can see. But in this, the inner tube was for the expiratory gases. That is the difference. Examiner can ask, what is inner tube of the Bain's is used for inspiration and expiration? It is for inspiratory gases. Okay. This is a IST piece. This is a T. Inverted T. If I like this end, I will attach the patient, and this end I will attach the corrugated tubing, it will become this system, that is Maplacian E. That's why Maplacian system is also known as, Maplacian circuit is also known as IST piece. If IS, this is the IST piece or Maplacian E, if I attach the bag with a hole, the tail, it will become F circuit. That is used for the pediatric patient less than 20 kg or less than of 6 years of age. This is a CO2 absorbent that is in the transparent canister, soda line with indicator. Its optimum size is 4 to 8 mass. When 50 to 70% of soda line color is changed, we will replace the soda line. It is formed in the granules, not in the powder. You can see here. This is used for carbon dioxide absorption. It is a part of closed circuit. This is a mask for the infant and the neonates. This is a typical mask that is used for the pediatric patient. Under Becker Shosak mask, particularly for the neonates, because this mask is having the less dead space. Because whenever we apply the mask, it will increase the dead space. That increase in dead space we can't afford in neonates and the infants. That's why this specific mask is used, which is having less dead space. This is a face mask, anatomical mask that can be used for adults. This mask is a three parts. You can see this is a connector that will be attached to the circuit, and this is the body main part, and this is the seal. When we have to deliver the gases to the patient, that is mask is applied over the mouth and the nose, and this part, as this is the seal, this part will form the tight seal over the face, and the gases will be delivered to the patient. Okay, and now this is under peculiar mask. It is not for delivering the gases to the patient. It is used for open drop method. This is Schimmelbusch mask. This Schimmelbusch mask is used for open drop method to anesthetize the patient. But this mask is not used, but examiner can ask by showing you the image. Schimmelbusch mask. This is a laryngoscope, laryngoscope handle. Depending upon the different blades, there are the different types of laryngoscopes are there. This is McIntosh type of laryngoscope. You can see that there are different size of laryngoscope blades are there, and these McIntosh blades are curved blades. They are curved. McIntosh, they are curved blade. It is commonly used for the, most commonly used for the intubation, particularly in adult patients. This is another typical kind of blade of laryngoscope. This is, for example, handle. When this lever is pressed, when I will press this lever, this tip is movable. This tip is movable. So this laryngoscope blade is known as McCoy blade, and this is used for difficult intubation, because when you are not able to see the glottis and you are using this McCoy blade, when you will press this lever, it will lift the epiglottis. So it is an advantage in case of difficult intubation. This is McCoy blade. This is a video laryngoscope, indirect laryngoscopy. When this laryngoscope is introduced, there's a fiber optic wires are there. Due to this, this image is formed in this screen, and you will see the vocal cords. And by manipulating or by passing the endotracheal tube with stillet, you can intubate the patient. This is video laryngoscope type of video laryngoscope, where you are seeing the vocal cords indirectly. This is type of indirect laryngoscopy. You will see the image in the video. You can see there is a one camera is there that is attached by the fiber optic wires. When we do laryngoscopy, this is the tip of the laryngoscopic blade in the vallicula. You are able to see the different structure. This is, for example, we are able to see the only epiglottis, and vocal cords is just below this epiglottis. So depending upon this laryngoscopy view, when you are doing the laryngoscopy, that view is divided into four grades. That classification is known as Cormac-Lehane classification, depending upon the structures visualized. When you are able to see the whole vocal cords like this, it is a grade 1. If only you are see the only posterior part of the vocal cords and the artenoids, only posterior one. Here, complete vocal cords you are able to see, but here on the posterior parts, in class 3, you are able to see only the epiglottis. Class 3, this is 2. In class 4, even you can't see the epiglottis. That's examiner can ask you, showing the picture after the laryngoscopy, this is the view. Tell in which Cormac Lehane grade this patient be classified. So, complete posterior epiglottis and no epiglottis. Okay. This is the diameter index safety system. This is the pressure applied during the intubation over the precord cartilage to prevent the aspiration. In case of RSI means rapid sequence induction. In case of rapid sequence induction, when there are the chances of aspiration, we do the rapid sequence induction. And this precord pressure application is also known as Selig's maneuver. It is also known as Selig's maneuver. By applying the pressure over the precord cartilage, we are compressing the esophagus between the precord cartilage and the vertebral body. So there will be no regurgitation. This is a classical laryngoscope, laryngeal mask airway, sorry. This is the airway tube and this is the inflatable cuff that can be inflated with this inflation tube. On the turn side, you can see this airway tube will open here and gases will be delivered. And this is the inflation system by which the cuff can be inflated. And it is introduced blindly along the hard palate. And after insertion, it will take this position. That MCQ is many times asked. The tip of the laryngoscope after the proper positioning will reside over the upper opening of the esophagus. And when the gases will be delivered, they will go into the trachea. This is another modification of classical laryngeal mask airway. In this, other than this airway tube, this is the airway tube. Another tube is there, that is a gastric drainage tube parallel to it. And this tube traverses along the floor of the mask and open here. So you can see better in this diagram. This another drainage tube, gastric drainage tube, traverses along the floor of the mask and opens here. So just like classical LMA, when this PLMA is introduced, through this tube we can pass the nasogastric tube, we can do the suction. So we have the access to the esophagus and the stomach. So this is known as PLMA, proceed LMA, and it provides the better seal than the classical LMA. That is the advantage of proceed LMA. It comes into different sizes. Another modification of the LMA is this airway tube is having the peculiar curve. The anatomical curve tube is there and integrated handle, and one monitor is attached. And by this fiber optic wires, by fiber optic wires, image is formed in the this screen. If the structures which are present anterior to this mask, they will be visualized on the screen. So this instrument is known as C-track. This is known as C-track. It's a modification of laryngeal mask cable. You can remember as C, this is a camera. You can remember like C, when camera is attached to the LMA, then it becomes the C track. Under visual guidance, you can intubate and you can see the vocal cords. That is the advantage of C track. Another modification of laryngeal mask airway is intubating LMA. Intubating LMA, or also known as fast track. C-track was having the camera, but fast-track is used for intubation. Just like C-track, there is a one handle is there, and you can see that is another same, just like C-track, anatomically curved airway. And when it is placed, just like a classical LMA, when you will pass the endotracheal tube through this, and it will come out here, and it will go into the larynx. There's a special tubes are there, that is flexometallic tube. This tube will be passed into this airway tube and then tube will be stabilized with this stabilizer and this LMA will be removed. That's how we can intubate the patient with the help of intubating LMA. This is the part you can see. This is the endotracheal tube will be passed here. It will come out from here. This is the epiglottis elevator. This triangular part is known as epiglottis elevator. When this tube is passed, it will come out of this. And when the larynx is anterior, it will go into the trachea. This is another type of supraglottic airway. It is known as IGEL. It is having the non-inflating cuff. There is a mask that is made up of thermoelastic polymer. There is no need of inflating this. There is no inflation system is there. It is inserted just like laryngeal mask blindly. And when it is inserted, it will take the this position, and through this we can ventilate the patient. Just like proceal LMA, this is also having a parallel gastric drainage tube. That gastric drainage tube also open at the tip of the IGEL. So this supraglottic airway is a IGEL. This is another type of supraglottic airway. This is known as combi tube, means combination of tube. In this gadget, there the two tubes are there. You can see this one and this one, and two cuffs are there. Sorry, two inflation system and two cuffs are there. One cuff is large, one cuff is small. In this diagram, you can see this tube. One tube is longer one and it is having blind head. Another tube is shorter one that is having opening. So when this tube is inserted blindly into the mouth, it will go into the esophagus, and the both the cuffs are inflated. So when we ventilate through the tube that is a longer one, that is having the blind openings, and there are the openings between these two cuffs, so gases will come out from these openings, the patient will be ventilated. So that is the advantage of combi tube, that can blindly insert it when it will go into the esophagus. Longer tube, we ventilate. In some patients, when it go into the trachea, we will ventilate with the smaller tube, because smaller tube is having the patent opening, distal opening. This is a Venturi mask. This is Venturi mask. Venturi mask is a oxygen delivery system that provides a fixed performance. According to this color coding, this is a yellow colored Venturi mask. Yellow colored Venturi mask will provide, according to the color coding, blue, white, orange, yellow, red, green. Blue will provide at 24%, white 28%, this is 32, and that is 36, red is 40, and green maximum 60%. Another MCQ is asked, by Venturi mask, what is the maximum percentage of oxygen can be delivered? That is 60% by green one. By this one, we can provide up to 36% fixed performance. This is another type of oxygen delivery device, that is a nasal prongs, and these two small prongs will go into the nares and the oxygen will be delivered. Maximum 44% of oxygen can be delivered by nasal prongs. This is a type of variable performance device. This is a red rubber tube, you can see. This is non-transparent and this is having the cuff. This cuff is having low volume and high pressure type of cuff. So this can cause the ischemia of the trachea, so it cannot be used for longer duration. But this tube, you can say this is made up of PVC tube, polyvinyl chloride. This is transparent in comparison to the red rubber tube. But this tube is having the cuff just opposite to the red rubber tube. This is having high volume and the low pressure cuff. This is the difference. Yeah, this is transparent, but it is radiopaque. There is a black radiopaque line is there inside this tube. This is a HME filter. This side will attach to the endotracheal tube and this side to the circuit. HME filter, heat and moisture exchanger. This is a tube used for the segregation of the lung. If this, for example, this tube is passed into the trachea, this is the right bronchus, this is the left bronchus. By this blocker, bronchial blocker, if this blocker is inserted into the right bronchus and I inflate this bronchus, so that's how I can segregate the both the lungs. The patient will be ventilated by these tubes, only the left lung will be ventilated, because the right lung is blocked by this block. This is used for thoracic surgery. This is double lumen tube. Double lumen tube. This tube is also in the two tubes joined together. One is opening here, another is here. This is also used for segregating the lung. When we can't use the double lumen tubes, we can use this blocker tube, bronchial blocker tube. These are the preformed shape tubes. Normally the endotracheal tubes are of this shape, but you can see these tubes are already preformed. In this tube is bended towards the same. If this end will go into the trachea, this tube is again going towards that end. But this tube is going to the other end. So these are the preformed or the RAE tube. RAE means they are named after the scientist who made them, Ring Adair Elvin. And this is going downwards after intubation, so it is known as South Pole. And it is known as North Pole. It is known as North Pole parade. This is another peculiar kind of endotracheal tube. You can see simple PVC tube. When it is bended, there is a kinking of the tube. You can see kinking is there. When this is another special type of tube where the wire is inside the endotracheal tube, this is known as flexometallic tube. There is a wire inside the tube, so this tube is flexible because there is a wire. So this tube is used where there are chances of kinking and the compression. They are non-kinking tube. This is another special kind of tube where you will find two cuffs. You can see two cuffs are there. These tubes are used for laser surgeries. For example, if the laser surgery you are using, by chance if the due to laser, if one cuff is injured, cuff is ruptured, another cuff will protect the airway from the aspiration. There are two cuffs are there, two inflation systems are there. This is a stilet, can be used for intubating the patient. This is made up of malleable metal. This stilet is inserted into the endotracheal tube, and endotracheal tube can be given a particular shape and can be used in case of difficult intubation. When the patient, this is a normal patient, you can see this is a tongue, airway is patent. When the patient is anesthetized, this tongue will fall posteriorly and it obstructs the airway. In that case, to make the airway patent, we use the airway. This is the nasopharyngeal airway. NPA, nasopharyngeal airway. Nasopharyngeal airway are passed through the nose so that airway can be make patent. You can see there, nasopharyngeal air is passed, so the airway becomes patent. And this is a type of oropharyngeal airway. Girdles. There are the many types of oropharyngeal airway. One of them is girdles. Instead of nares, it is passed into the oral cavity and make the airway patent. This is a spinal needle. quinque spinal needle, you can see this is a stellate. When tip is inside the subarachnoid space, stellate is removed, CSF will come and we inject the drug. The different kinds of spinal needles are there. If the dura cutting, it is type of quinque, and this is the Whittaker, and the scroti, you can see these are pencil tip. These are type of dura separating needles. This is a Tohi's needle used for epidural anesthesia. This is a stellate. When we are in epidural space, stellate is removed, we can pass the catheter. You can see this is the catheter. Catheter is passed. And this is a syringe that is used for loss of resistance. Special syringes that are used for epidural block. These are color coding for the IV cannulas. You can see this is a 24 according to color coding, 14 orange, 16 gray, 18 green, 20 pink, 22 blue, and 26 violet. This needle is used for the nerve stimulation, nerve blocks. For example, this is a nerve. Through this particular needle, when I give the small amount of the current through this port, if tip is nearby the nerve will be stimulated. That's how I can localize the nerve and inject the drug. This is used for nerve block. This is nerve stimulating needle. This is the AED. This question was asked in the AIIMS 2019 November only. AED, automated external defibrillator. This is the manual defibrillator. This is a part of ACLS, not BLS. This is a cream that is applied over the intact skin. That is Amla cream, contains lignocaine and pirlocaine in 1:1 ratio. This is now neuromuscular monitoring, most commonly now used, that is ulnar nerve, and muscle that is monitored is adductor pollicis. And this is a landmark of which block you can. This is a sacral hiatus that is formed after the non-fusion of S4, S5 lamina. We can give the drug through this sacral hiatus. That block is known as chordal block because the part of the epidural space inside the sacrum is known as chordal space. By using this landmark, we can give the chordal block. Okay, guys.